Hello there, Ivan here, bringing you updates on the Nucleotide game development. In the last development diary, I show you the static model of the main character, and in this video, you are witnessing his first moves. As Dr. Frankenstein said,
"It's alive! It's alive! It's alive!"
Right now, there are only two states of animation, idle and swim. Animations are done in Blender and implemented using Mecanim technology. Mecanim, in layman's terms, is an animation system which provides much easier way to integrate your animations into a Unity game. It would take much more time to achieve the same result with the old animation system, pre-Unity 4.0, so way to go, developers of Unity! Before I started work on animations, player speed was linear. As you can see, that is no longer the case. I went for a more natural speed regulation, which follows character's animations, so it looks like he's pushing himself out of the water, and he needs some time to change his direction. Additionally, I expanded the floating bodies to support animated objects. I'm able to decide which bones are affecting the water surface, and I'm calculating velocity for each of them to make the interactions with the water surface look natural. So if the player character, for example, makes some crazy move, the water will behave properly. Also, I tweaked the water shader a bit, but this is not the final version of it since there are no reflections nor refractions. For all of you who were worrying about the clouds not moving, don't worry anymore, I will change that in the future. Leave a comment, tell me what you think, subscribe if you're not, and click the like button. This week was my father's name day, and since I know he's a regular watcher, Čale, sretan imendan. I hope you like this. My name is Ivan Mandić. Bye.